We might think that the luscious tenderness, the golden sweetness of this corn on the cob had its beginnings back in the time seeds were placed in the ground. Yet, actually, the beginnings go back even further than that, back to years of work done by men like John McCabe, a specialist in vegetable development. Mr. McCabe, aided by seed breeder Dalton Ozan, set up definite specifications for a new sweet corn hybrid, representing the things most wanted by home gardeners, commercial growers, and canners. For example, they wanted an ear with light silk because the dark silk shows up unattractively as dark strings when canned. They all wanted an easy picker, adaptable to both hand picking and machine picking. Deep, narrow kernels to assure high cutting percentage. And they wanted a heavy yielder, the large two-ear kind. And instead of many varieties, each capable of growing only in a restricted area, a single variety was wanted, resistant to temperature extremes of hot and cold, rugged enough to grow across the country. An early maturing hybrid was wanted, one giving a harvest of mature ears days before standard varieties ripen. And above all, top quality, measured by tenderness and sweetness of kernel. They got what they wanted. All these specifications were bred into one sweet corn hybrid. The goodness, the growing and producing ability, the early maturity, all this came about because Mr. McCabe selected two lines that had been made true and pure by years of inbreeding. Inbreeding is the process of pollinating a plant year after year with its own pollen, taking great care to exclude stray pollen. Crossing began